wise man once told me, the road to hell is paved with good intentions.
Mission accomplished, May 1st, 2003. Over 3 years later, we still face the insurgency. 133,000 dead for supposed democracy. But then again, the first reason was WMDs. Never found those, so they proposed something like a loophole in the equation for woe, and we accept for lost souls. Cause can't accept a mistake for the death toll. That hurts too much to face truth, shed a few and let go. But we know it's more than meets the eye, independent of the fact if we were ever told a lie. Incompetence enough to ask the leadership why, and objectively criticize. It's what a patriot does in hard times, so we can learn to be better and truly epitomize the principles you proselytize while we eulogize lost lives and try to have it make sense. Meanwhile, oil execs are counting dollars and cents. Coffins draped in flags, shed a tear for moms and dads from home to Baghdad. Come on, coffins draped in flags. Will they ever come home? The situation's so sad. Coffins draped in flags, shed a tear for moms and dads from home to Baghdad. Come on, coffins draped in flags. Will they ever come home? The situation's so sad.
More than 40 times of lives lost in 9/11, and 10 times just for the lives of Iraqi civilians. 283 billion and counting is what we're spending. But terror, alive and well, and seems further from ending. What's really being defended if Al-Qaeda had no ties to Iraq until it shock and awe we attacked? Gotta laugh out loud to keep them crying over that, and the fact that we now find ourselves caught or trapped up in a bind. How do we find a way out? Is this the best way to be about the business of taking out terrorism when we've given them another place to respect their religion? So if we leave now, we all know that it's a given. We'll be thought of as you're scared to fight for what's supposedly right. The conundrum, man, is squeezing this tight. Same time, we on our knees and we praying at night, hoping for some sort of life so we can know we all right.
Coffins draped in flags, shed a tear for moms and dads from home to Baghdad. Come on, coffins draped in flags. Will they ever come home? The situation's so sad. Coffins draped in flags, shed a tear for moms and dads from home to Baghdad. Come on, coffins draped in flags. Will they ever come home? The situation's so sad.
Yes, Iraq may be a better place without Hussein, but is the world a safer place since we put him in chains? No doubt, a tough question, but this is the price of pain. Or better yet, the consequence of incompetence when it rains. Have we gained or have we really lost in this situation? Is this the best way to go about building nations? Bin Laden is still chasing. Here we are now faced with the harsh reality of future generations catching more hell than what was ever really necessary. Got us thinking to ourselves, this is more than just scary. Know you hear me loud and clear because I'm speaking the truth. I know it hurts, but this what happens when you jump without the shoot, or you shoot without a pen to execute. So now we left a question. The war a curse while the soldier a blessing. Need you stressing, cause that's the way I'm feeling right now. Don't got an answer or a solution, a when or a how.
Coffins draped in flags, shed a tear for moms and dads from home to Baghdad. Come on, coffins draped in flags. Will they ever come home? The situation's so sad. Coffins draped in flags, shed a tear for moms and dads from home to Baghdad. Come on, coffins draped in flags. Will they ever come home? The situation's so sad.
Terror does not just come in brown, nor is it new. Evil lives in us all, so we must fight with love and goodness in our hearts and peace in our minds, if democracy, equality, and freedom are truly to prevail. God bless America. God bless Iraq. God bless us all.